Hey guys, it's my birthday book haul. I got a total of 7 books, so let's get going. The first 3 books that I got at a Second in Charles, which is a used bookstore. The first book I got is Timeless by Gail Carriger, and this is the 5th book in the Parasol Protectorates series. I have yet to actually start reading this series, but I've managed to find all 5 of these books at a used bookstore for like $3 a piece, so I've kind of just been slowly gathering them all because I kind of intend to read them all in one go when I do get to them. And this series, if you've not watched my other videos where I've talked about this series, it takes place in Victorian London, if I'm not mistaken, and it's like about werewolves and vampires and just other supernatural type creatures. The next book that I got is Death Comes to Pemberley by P.D. James, and this is a kind of, I guess, a creative retelling of Pride and Prejudice, but like taking place after Pride and Prejudice, and a murder occurs, and Darcy and Elizabeth have to kind of solve this murder, and deals a lot with Wickham. Wickham's involved in some manner. I've been really dying to read this book. I watched the little mini-series that aired couple months ago. It aired over in the UK. It hasn't aired here yet in the US, but it's supposed to, I think, in the summer maybe. I've kind of heard a lot of mixed reviews about this book, so I managed to find it for discount price just in case I don't like it, even though I did really enjoy the miniseries, so hopefully I enjoyed the book just as much. And the last book that I bought at Second Charles is The Three Musketeers by Alexandre Dumas. And I have been really wanting to read this. I've seen the 2 movie adaptations, the one that had Chris O'Donnell and Charlie Sheen and Kiefer Sutherland, and then I also saw the most recent one with Logan Lerman and Matthew McFadden. So it's like, I kind of already know the story of the Three Musketeers, but I've never actually sat and read it. And I did a top 5 video quite a few months ago, talking about my 5 authors that I have not read yet but I would like to read, and Alexandre Dumas was on that list. And I don't know if I need to explain what The Three Musketeers is. I think most everyone kind of knows what it is about on some level, but it's about like a boy named D'Artagnan who's living in France. I think this takes place kind of before the French Revolution. I don't think it's during the French Revolution. D'Artagnan meets up with these 3 musketeer dudes and they go on some adventures, and there's a lot of stuff involving like the King and Queen of France. And I also have the intention of reading this quite soon because I would like to read this before BBC America shows The Musketeers. The Musketeers is starting over here in June, I believe, and I'd love to do a book to screen on that. So yes, I need to read this kind of soon. And then the next 4 books I got at Barnes & Noble. The first one is American Gods by Neil Gaiman. And this is the version that I believe is most recommended because it says it's the author's preferred text here at the bottom. And Neil Gaiman was also on my list of top 5 authors that I have not read yet that I would like to read. And to be honest, I don't quite know what American Gods is about. I think it's one of those books that when I've seen reviews for it, it's one of those books that's it's hard to explain what the synopsis is. Even looking on the back about what the synopsis is, I don't even think I can even begin to tell you what it is about. But yes, apparently this is one of Neil Gaiman's masterpieces, and I wanted to make this like my first foray into Neil Gaiman. Next, I got The Forbidden Queen by Anne O'Brien, and this tells the story of Catherine of Valois. I hope I am pronouncing her name correctly. Catherine of Valois, who was Henry V's wife. And this is a brand new release, just released like last month, I think, and I'm pretty excited to read this. And up here it claims that it's better than Philippa Gregory, and you know how much I love Philippa Gregory. Then I got The Secret Daughter of the Tsar by Jennifer Lamb. And the synopsis for this sounds really fantastic. It takes place, I believe, in kind of both historical Russia, but also in the present. And it's like the daughter's kind of saying, the secret daughter of the Tsar. And I think it's focusing on another girl that was possibly Tsar Nicholas II's daughter. And that they're looking for an heir to the Russian throne. And this is also a relatively new release, and I've been dying to get my hands on this because I love Russian-related Romanov historical fiction, so this should be pretty exciting. And then the last book that I got from Barnes & Noble is Tsarina by J. Neil Patrick. And I found this in the YA section. I think this was literally released just a few weeks ago. It's about a girl who is in love with Alexei Romanov, who is the heir to the Russian throne. And there's something having to do with a secret message in a Fabergé egg, and I'm really excited to read this. So I actually ended up getting two historical Russian Romanov-related books, which is funny. So that's it for my birthday book haul. I had a lot of fun going out and buying all these books. I've never really bought this many books in one time. Don't know if something's wrong with me. Are you guys excited to read any of these books? Have you heard about any of these books? Is there any that you would like me to read first? Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.